The WWC conducts systematic reviews of research under a variety of topic areas. For example, the WWC reviews research in the areas of literacy, math, and science, as well as research on student populations, such as pre-K students, K-12 students, post-secondary students, English learners, and students with disabilities. The WWC has developed an overall set of standards and procedures to review education research. These are described in the WWC Procedures and Standards Handbooks available on the WWC website. In addition to these overall standards and procedures, each WWC review is guided by a review protocol, also available on the WWC website, which outlines additional review parameters and procedures specific to the topic area of interest. The WWC systematic review process includes 5 steps. Define the scope of the review, search the literature, assess the research, combine the findings, and finally, summarize the review. The first step is to define the scope of the review. Before any review effort, the WWC develops a formal review protocol to guide reviews for a specific topic area. The WWC staff who lead the review effort, including experts on methodology and content, develop the protocol to ensure that it reflects issues and considerations that are relevant to the topic area. The review protocol describes studies that are eligible for review, how the WWC will search for them, and how the WWC will review them. It serves as a guide for every step of the systematic review process. First, the protocol describes the types of interventions eligible for review under that topic area. These can include programs, products, practices, or policies. Second, the protocol defines the outcome measures that are eligible for review and groups them into sets of closely related measures called outcome domains. Third, the protocol defines the criteria that studies must meet to be eligible for review, such as specifying the populations of interest to the review. For example, a protocol might require that the studies focus on students of a particular age or grade range. Fourth, the protocol outlines how the WWC will search for eligible studies. Specifically, the protocol specifies the relevant time frame, search terms to use, and topic-specific sources to search. Finally, the protocol specifies key details about how the WWC will review those studies, including approaches for any areas of discretion for topic areas provided in the WWC Standards Handbook. Such areas might include whether the reviews use an optimistic or pessimistic attrition threshold, and the characteristics that studies may use to satisfy the baseline equivalence requirement. All review protocols are posted on the WWC website. Visit the Resources section on the online training page to find a link to all WWC review protocols. To illustrate the steps of the systematic review process, we will look at some details of the systematic review of the intervention READ 180 for the adolescent literacy topic area completed in November of 2016. The WWC reviewed research examining the effectiveness of the READ 180 intervention under the Review Protocol for Adolescent Literacy Interventions, version 3.0. This review protocol states that eligible interventions must focus on the effects of a reading or literacy intervention on one or more eligible outcome measures. The protocol describes eligible outcomes in the alphabetics, reading fluency, comprehension, and general literacy achievement domains. To be eligible for review under the protocol, studies must focus on students in grades 4 to 12 and must have been released in 1989 or later. The protocol also specifies details about how attrition and baseline equivalence should be assessed. We'll return to this READ 180 systematic review as we move through the remaining steps of the systematic review process. After we develop the review protocol to define the scope of our review, we perform a comprehensive search for relevant education studies. The WWC searches a variety of electronic databases and websites to identify relevant studies. The WWC Procedures Handbook identifies sources that we typically search regardless of the topic area, and the review protocol specifies additional topic-specific sources. Research included in WWC systematic reviews must be publicly available, such as journal articles, reports, working papers, papers presented at conferences, and doctoral dissertations. When the WWC reviews research on a specific intervention, we also contact its developer to share the list of studies we've found that tested the intervention and ask if the developer is aware of additional studies that our initial search did not find. The WWC Procedures Handbook provides more information about the approach used to perform the literature search. In this second step of the systematic review process for the systematic review of READ 180, we conducted a literature search guided by the Review Protocol for Adolescent Literacy Interventions. This protocol lists search terms relevant to the topic area and relevant additional sources, such as the National Reading Panel. The search produced 208 citations. In the next steps, these 208 citations were screened for eligibility, and those that met eligibility criteria were reviewed against WWC evidence standards. Ultimately, the WWC reported on and summarized findings from only a subset of these 208 citations that meet WWC design standards. The third step of the systematic review process is a thorough assessment of the quality of evidence each study provides on the effectiveness of the intervention or group of interventions that is the focus of the systematic review. This process includes two components: screening for eligibility to identify relevant effectiveness studies, and reviewing those effectiveness studies against the WWC standards. First, we screen studies to determine whether they are eligible for review according to the requirements in the review protocol. Trained WWC screeners carry out the screening process. For example, a screener determines whether a study uses an eligible design to examine the effectiveness of an intervention of interest to the topic area. Because they are not original effectiveness studies, meta-analyses, newspaper articles, and implementation studies are screened out as ineligible. The screener also determines which of the remaining effectiveness studies are relevant to the systematic review, meaning that the studies meet the criteria outlined in the protocol related to outcomes and study sample characteristics. If the screener deems the study a relevant effectiveness study, and therefore eligible, a certified WWC reviewer verifies the study's eligibility. For the READ 180 intervention report, the WWC determined that 156 of the 208 citations identified in the literature search were effectiveness studies. The rest of the citations represented a range of publications, news articles, advertisements, trainings, and so on. Only 39 of those 156 studies used an eligible design and met the adolescent literacy protocol criteria, making them eligible for review. Then, after screening the studies identified in the literature search, the WWC reviews eligible studies against the WWC design standards. Reviewers closely examine the methods used in the study, apply the WWC design standards as outlined in the WWC Standards Handbook, and assign one of three ratings to the study: meets WWC design standards without reservations, meets WWC design standards with reservations, or does not meet WWC design standards. Reviewers document their work in a study review guide, which describes the details of the review and the rating assigned. At least two certified reviewers review each eligible study, including a senior member of the review team. If the first reviewer assigns a rating of meets WWC design standards with or without reservations to a study, or thinks that a study could possibly receive one of those ratings with some additional information from the study authors, then a second reviewer will independently review the study. The senior member of the review team then considers both reviews and finalizes the study's rating. However, if the first reviewer assigns a rating of does not meet WWC design standards, the senior member of the review team will review the study and attempt to confirm the rating without sending the study to a second reviewer. If the senior member of the review team believes the study could meet WWC design standards, then a second reviewer will independently review the study. The senior member of the review team will then consider both reviews and finalize the study's rating. In some cases, the two independent reviewers may provide different assessments of a study. For example, reviewers could disagree on the final study rating because of differences in the assessment of outcomes that are eligible for review. When disagreements occur, the senior review team member will work together with the two reviewers to determine the rating.
If necessary, the WWC asks the study authors for additional information needed to complete the review.
For more information on the study review process, please see the WWC process briefs on screening and the review process on the WWC website. Returning to our example, of the 39 studies screened as eligible for the READ 180 review, only 9 were rated meets WWC design standards. 3 studies were rated meets WWC design standards without reservations, and 6 were rated meets WWC design standards with reservations. The inverted triangle in this example shows how few studies ultimately meet WWC design standards. The systematic review process starts with a broad, comprehensive literature search, but a smaller number of studies ultimately meet WWC design standards. The WWC systematic review reports only on findings within this small group of studies. After assessing the research, we combine the findings from reviews of individual studies to summarize what was learned about the effectiveness of the intervention. Because studies can report findings from multiple outcomes or samples, combining findings occurs both within a study and across studies. We describe the magnitude of findings related to the effectiveness of the intervention, the amount of supporting evidence, and the ability to generalize findings. Returning to the READ 180 example, the WWC summarized the findings from the 9 studies that meet WWC design standards in the READ 180 systematic review. These included findings in each of the 4 eligible outcome domains in the review protocol. The reporting module, which is Module 7, discusses how the WWC combines and summarizes findings in more detail. The last step in the process is to summarize the findings from the review in a report or other product. The WWC produces 2 primary products that are the result of systematic reviews. First, WWC intervention reports include reviews of all the available research on a particular intervention. Second, WWC practice guides offer evidence-based recommendations for educators to address challenges in their classrooms and schools. Practice guides don't focus on single interventions. Instead, they summarize the evidence associated with the suggested practices. On the WWC website, the WWC also summarizes reviews of individual studies identified outside of systematic reviews. For example, the WWC will sometimes provide quick assessments of studies that receive media attention. Although the WWC does not identify these individual study reviews as part of a systematic search of the literature, we conduct them using the same procedures and standards that we apply in systematic reviews, using the Review of Individual Studies protocol. WWC products summarize findings only from studies that meet WWC design standards. However, WWC products include all studies that were screened in as effectiveness studies of an intervention of interest in the reference list. The result of the WWC's systematic review process is a report that summarizes and synthesizes findings from studies that meet standards, including positive effects, negative effects, and findings of no effect. In the case of the READ 180 review, we summarized the findings from the 9 studies that met WWC design standards with or without reservations in an intervention report. The intervention report includes the table we discussed in Step 4 that summarizes the findings within each of the 4 outcome domains, as well as additional detail about the studies and their findings. Occasionally, a systematic review identifies no studies that meet WWC design standards. When this occurs, the WWC releases a report indicating that the WWC is unable to draw any conclusions about the effectiveness or ineffectiveness of the intervention.